I remember a moonlit night, and I was walking all alone down a pebble-laden path. Walking.
Why are we here? And what comes next? These are questions we as a species have obsessed over, quandaries our greatest thinkers have spent their lives contemplating, and themes our media has explored in increasingly interesting ways. Whilst they are utterly grounded, human questions, they've always benefited from our most fantastical books, movies, and television shows. Anime has always been a great platform for philosophical pondering, and plenty of series have attempted to tackle these eternal inquiries. In the early 2000s, a short-lived show came along that had its otherworldly leads framing these questions against beautiful watercolour vistas and amongst a cheery ensemble cast. But this upbeat aesthetic was a deceptive one. In fact, Haibane Renmei is one of the most misleading shows I've come across in my 20 years of watching anime, and one that desperately demands more attention and ever closer inspection. Because within its 13-episode core, we see a lot of ourselves, our own insecurities and pessimistic doubts within the angelic beings known as the Haibane. Their wings and halos may insinuate that they are different, but as the group spirals towards a sobering midsection, and those questions seem to consume these haunted people in ever more destructive ways, it's hard not to see yourself in the angels of old home. Springing from the self-published sketches of Yoshitoshi ABe, Haibane Renmei began life as a simple doujinji series. ABe, who worked for a time under the pen name ABe, got his start not with manga, but with graffiti, until getting his big break designing characters for the seminal Serial Experiments Lane. Around the same time, he began penning the first issue of Charcoal Feather Federation, a precursor to Haibane Renmei. Amateur manga like this, sold independently at doujin fairs such as Comiket, is a wonderful breeding ground for some of the most captivating adaptations out there. And sure enough, within a few publications, the series was snapped up for a short animated run. ABe discontinued the doujinji shortly after, choosing instead to use the anime to conclude his story. ABe is a uniquely disparate voice in manga and anime. He draws the majority of his work on a tablet, often with his finger, somehow wringing that signature, haunted look from his characters by using the bluntest of instruments. And this delicate art is tainted by a pervasive, intangible sense of darkness. In Haibane Renmei, it feels especially prevalent, though he masterfully balances it with a wonderfully warm, incredibly expressive cast. With his dreamlike artistry serving the ethereal subject matter wonderfully well, ABe laid a solid foundation for what would follow. A series that swings between despair and hope equally, a show that is as uplifting as it is melancholic, and a run that is utterly, indelibly, Yoshitoshi ABe. In a sleepy town surrounded by idyllic countryside and dense woodland, the Haibane are not birthed but instead reborn from large eggs that sprout within places that angels gather. They burst from these cocoons with no memory of the life they have left behind, and given new names based on the strange dreams they have during their incubation. It's in the residence of Old Home, a huge, dilapidated and largely abandoned dormitory that has become a Haibane nest, that the show establishes its soul. The wild and youthful Ku and Kana give a pulse to the otherwise pensive nature of the proceedings. Hikari, the resident baker, aptly brings a wholesome sweetness to the group, and the level-headed and ever-sleepy Nemu provides a fixed point upon which everyone seems to orient themselves around. Finally, there is Reki, one of the older Haibane, who presents a bit of a paradox. She's quick to anger, but calm in an emergency. Childish and mothering in equal measure. Nurturing, but somewhat closed off. It feels like her story is stuck and waiting for a catalyst. And it's with the emergence of Raka, the latest to join Old Home, that things are finally put in motion. With the new feather as our proxy, we're introduced to the town of Glee, the intimidating, insurmountable walls that surround it, the strange customs they observe, and the Haibane's place within it all. It's a cozy and comfortable setup, with plenty of intrigue to keep the leisurely pacing of the run engaging. Innocently enough, the show sets up its many mysteries. Why have the Haibane fractured into separate communities? Why is their coexistence with humans such a dependent one? And who are the strange masked mutes known as the Haibane Renmei? But, as I warned, this show is a deceptive one, and its first real deceit is tricking you into thinking it cares to resolve any of these lingering questions. Instead, as the pace picks up and episode bleeds into episode, you realise its focus is squarely on the philosophical and often religious struggles of our leads. Whilst Abe has stated that the typically theistic visuals used to portray the Haibane was simply an aesthetic choice, the rest of the show leans into the associations such imagery conjures, obsessing over themes such as damnation, redemption, faith, and original sin. As Raka discovers more about her new home, her new family, and her new life, she begins asking the questions the show is actually interested in exploring. The same questions we've always asked. Why are we here? And what comes next? Which brings us to the second, more troubling deceit. The very idea that this was ever the warm, fluffy title it made itself out to be. We're clued in early on when, during the opening episode, the facade slips for a moment. But that bloody memory fades long before the show truly reveals its hand. Because, as much as it would like to be, Haibane Renmei isn't about an angel coming to terms with her new life. It's about the pain of letting her old one go. As Raka starts asking these all-important questions, the layers peel back to reveal a character study that is harrowingly introspective, deeply obsessive, and often distressingly dark. The broken cast each deal with their loss of self in unique ways, and for a show that affirms the importance of ascension, of moving on, its leads are all too quick to dwell in the stifling sadness that penetrates the latter half of the season. Haibane Renmei explores, with chilling but earnest insight, depression, self-harm and suicide. These beats are handled with a deft touch, exhibiting a compassion and subtlety I'm not used to seeing from anime when it comes to such bleak, nihilistic themes. But the true masterstroke here is that, despite it all, Haibane remains wonderfully hopeful. As Haibane Renmei approaches its breathtaking conclusion, a striking and memorable finale that has stuck with me throughout the years since I first saw it, I couldn't help but be caught up in its swell of optimistic closure. Many have posited that the town, whose residents are trapped within its walls, acts as some sort of purgatory, and this sense of limbo extends to the storytelling too. A sense that we're seeing the middle part of a story we'll never fully understand, whose beginning and end will always remain a mystery to us. But on the blurred boundaries of its season, the promise of new life, redemption, and, most importantly, meaning, exists. It may take you a lifetime to decipher that meaning, to learn to appreciate its message, but it's a message that's absolutely worth your time, that's worth watching and rewatching the show to reach and to understand. Because within its hauntingly beautiful, bittersweet goodbye, it sings of love, of support, of learning not only to forgive others, but also ourselves. A message that affirms, above all else, you are not alone.
Thank you.
As always, thanks for watching. Haibane is a pretty personal show, with a huge range of takeaways depending on how you approach it, and I think that's why this script took longer than usual to write. So apologies for the delay. With any luck, the next release won't take quite so long. It was an absolute treat to get more acquainted with the beautiful art of the ridiculously talented Yoshitoshi ABe, but if you have an artist and a series you'd love for me to check out, now is your chance. On the 3rd of August, I'll be asking my lovely patrons to recommend me a single volume of manga each. So pledge a buck, and I'll check out your favourite, and make a quick video on what I thought of the bunch. If, instead, you want to recommend me a manga you think I'll absolutely hate, hit the like button, and I'll set up a bizarro Patreon, so you can do just that.